Dear friends, welcome to our channel. Our topic today on Muslim law is grounds of divorce for Muslim women. So this is very important topic. As you are aware that in Muslim law, majority of the authority of divorce or talaq is in the hand of husband, and very less authority or in terms of right is available to the woman. In India, there was one act passed in 1939, that is Dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act. Through this act, certain grounds were made available to Muslim women, and if they are aggrieved because of the any of the ground mentioned in section 2 of this act, they can seek divorce on such ground. So let us see these various grounds as a class, then we will discuss in detail one by one. So these are 9 listed grounds in section 2 of Dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act 1939. You can see on the screen one by one: missing of husband, failure to maintain by husband, imprisonment of husband, failure to perform marital obligation, impotency of husband, insanity, leprosy, and virulent disease, option of puberty, cruelty of husband, or any other ground recognized by Shariat law like Lian or Faskh, etc. So let us see in detail one by one what are the ground and what are the different conditions. Missing of husband. In case husband is missing for more 4 years or more continuously, and nobody in general is aware where is husband, where is that man, then wife has right to seek decree for dissolution of marriage under this ground, and court, after satisfying these conditions, may give decree for dissolution, and which will be come into force after 6 months from the date of issue. The idea is, if within 6 months from the issue of decree his husband made himself in person present in front of court, such decree will be dissolved or will be null and void. So this is one ground available to the Muslim woman for seeking divorce or dissolution of marriage. Second ground is failure to maintain. If a husband is failed to maintain his wife for 2 years continuously, then wife has right to seek divorce from husband, and it may be the cases whether it is willful or he is not able to maintain due to poverty, there was no job of husband, because maintenance of wife is absolute responsibility of husband, irrespective of whether he is earning or not earning. It is his duty to maintain. So if this duty is failed to maintain by husband, it is a ground for wife to get divorce. It should be for continuously for 2 years. The third one is imprisonment of husband. So due to any conviction or any charges, husband has been sentenced more than or up to 7 years of imprisonment, and the final judgment has been given and period of appeal has been over, if any, then that date onward, wife has a valid ground to seek divorce on this ground. The fourth one is failure to perform marital obligation for 3 years or more. So if continuously 3 years or more husband is not performing his marital liability, then wife has right to seek crown. On this ground, she can apply for the divorce. The fifth one is impotency of the husband. If wife applying on this ground, impotency of the husband, then nothing will be asked from wife on this ground. This is very interesting. It is husband who has to prove that he is potent within 1 year from the decree. For example, if court has given decree for dissolution of marriage, so her husband has to give enough evidence that he is not potent. He is not impotent, he is potent. Then only court, based on these evidence, may made this decree null and void, otherwise this will be valid. Next one is insanity. So insanity is a valid ground. Wife can seek divorce. And such disease like leprosy or virulent disease in communicable form are also valid ground for seeking divorce. The seventh is option of puberty. So in case wife was minor at the time of marriage, and on attaining the age of puberty, in simple way, attaining the age of majority, she has right to repudiate such marriage, and on this ground she can apply for dissolution or annulment of such marriage. So she has to do it as per Indian law at attaining the age of 15 to 18 years. In between 15 to 18 years, foremost condition is there should be no consummation or cohabitation happen between husband and wife. Okay, then wife can apply for seeking divorce. Eighth one is cruelty of husband. The cruelty is nowhere defined in law, and cruelty term is very large actually. It covers a whole lot of things. It may be a physical abusing, physical torture like beating, and it may be emotional torture also. Both emotional cruelty and physical cruelty can be ground for divorce as a right of wife from husband. There was a case in which husband bring another wife, and previous wife was not comfortable in same home with second wife, so mentally disturbed. So that was considered as a valid ground for seeking divorce. So on the basis of cruelty also, wife can seek divorce from husband. Last one is any other ground. So as per Shariat law, if there are other grounds like Lian or Faskh, like husband is putting some allegation of adultery on wife and that is ultimately proved false, then through Faskh, wife can apply for divorce. So dear friend, we saw all the grounds available as per dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act. Those are available to wife. I hope these are clear to all of us. Thank you very much for seeing this video. Please put your comments if you have any query, and please subscribe, like and comments. Thank you very much.